Hello everybody and welcome back again to Dragon Age Inquisition. We are currently fighting our way through the Abo Wilds and try to reach the Elven Temple, preferably before Corypheus does. I really don't know who these guys are, by the way, but there must be some of my allies. Anyway, before I continue, I want to backtrack a little bit because I saw what seems to be another way. Yeah, let me have a look at this place as well. I already see some red arrows on my map, so presumably there are some more enemies around. Well, I can't go through here. Let's continue this way. Oh, okay. This works. Let me help my soldiers over here. There we go. Let me taunt all of you and let me shatter you. Very nice. And one of those horrors. Why don't you come over here and step in this mine, please? And yeah, there are some of those elves as well. Alright. Yeah, look at that. Interesting. And that's another supply cache, but I'm going to leave this in case I need it later. Mehmet's Warhammer. I don't think it's better what Iron Bull has, especially since I crafted the weapon specifically for him, and it's made of Dawnstone. Official looking letter to all captains of the Red Templars. We are not stopping to deal with these elven fanatics. Press forward, post more guards, and handle the ambushes as they come. Finding the Temple of Mythal is our first and only task. Once I become the vessel, our master can finally claim the power waiting for him. No elves, no city, no nation will be a match for a living god. This is a day we've bled for. The Inquisition and our legions are snapping at our heels, and you've sacrificed more than anyone should ask, but if we fall here, the death of our brothers and sisters meant nothing. I won't let that happen. I know none of you will either. For the glory of the Elder One, General Samson. Oh dear. There's loot on top of his tent. I don't even know how that got there, and if I'll be able to get there. Yes, I can. Alright. Okay, yeah, let's move on, I guess. Can we... Okay, so we can move over here. But, ooh. Yeah, I'm not interested in that right now, but I saw something. Yes, there is more stuff over here. Yeah. Some elven runes, apparently. And more Red Templars, of course. And shattered and dead. Oh, there's somebody still alive. And not anymore. Iron Bull. There we go. Nice. Okay. So what did I find here? Certainly a Veilfire, so maybe we can look around this place a bit. Lots of Philanderers, take it. Although I can actually plant Philanderers myself now because I found some seed and I actually have some of them growing in my garden right now. Okay, let's have a look at this. Codex unlocked, Old Elven Writing. Okay, I don't know, should I have a look at this? It'll be kinda hard to find in all those. I'm just going to assume that it is in letters and notes. And they are sorted. Well, it's not here. Yeah, I will have a look for that later. I don't want to spend my time doing that now. Once I've ended the episode, I will try to find that codex. Just in case it's something important. Yeah, I think there's nothing else over here. So I guess we can move on. Alright, and I probably don't need the Veilfire anymore, so let's get rid of that. So yeah, let me go back to where we came from and... Oh, hang on a second. Did these guys just respawn? Well, I mean, they're easy enough to kill, so let's help our soldiers here. And yeah, there's again one of those elven sentinels. Be happy with this. And yeah, I gotta say, Iron Bull is doing a lot better now with the new armor. I think that was a good idea. Although, I mean, we haven't really been in a tough fight so far, so we'll see about this later, I guess. Anyway, let's move out. I still don't need the supply cache. So okay, this is where we fought the two behemoths, right?
We'll hold these monsters, Inquisitor! The free mages stand with the light!
Ah, okay, these are my mage allies, I guess. Okay, this makes sense. I still don't know who those people down there are, though. Just some random allies I have gathered, I take it. But yeah, those are apparently the mages that I brought into the Inquisition. Very nice. Okay, let's move on. Look at those parrots. And more of them. Quite a bunch of them, actually, so maybe this is a nice time for a pull of the abyss, but you need to come closer for this. So let's try this again. Yeah, let's try it like this. And now let's put an ice mine in the center of it.
It's way to go.
Ah, works. Works every time. Works every time. I love it. Okay, now let me take care of this guy over here. Shattered. And one last one over here. And there we go. All right. Okay, I'm not interested in the Arbor Blessing. We'll take the Storm Heart. And Okay, this is apparently the way where I didn't have to go. But what is this way? Is there something of interest over here? Yeah, let me check this out before I continue down the river. Apparently we have some more ruins over here.
Good hunting, Inquisitor. We are keeping them at bay. Follow the river to the temple.
Oh, I see. I think this is Liliana over there. Nice. Well, I can spare some time and help you with it over here. Right. I see Morrigan is the one with the electricity spells around here. Been wondering who was doing that. And a few more attempters. Oh, let me get out of here. Not sure if this was actually a hostile mine. I mean, it could have been from one of our mage allies, right? So maybe it was not a hostile mine. Yeah, there are some friendly mages around. And another supply cache that I don't need. So, is there anything around here that is actually worth looking at? Let me have a quick look. Also, where exactly is Liliana? Is she still around, or maybe she moved on? Yeah, I don't know. This seems to be mostly a dead end. So in that case, I should probably just go back to my main objective. Alright, sorry for the cut again, but believe it or not, my game just crashed. This is actually the first time, I think, that this game ever crashed on me. It basically just shut down for no reason whatsoever. But luckily there was a save very shortly before the point that it crashed, so I just came back here to this place where we left off, and we can now move on to our next objective, which is the final blockade. Yeah, let's go and see what we have to do here. I think this is where we leave this area. Yeah. I think this is the right way. And now we just move down the river. Anyway, let me take care of this guy first. Alright. And we have some Templars over here.
Die!
Done. All right. What's going on? Are you okay? All right, let's move on. I already see the next wave of enemies. Well, that guy just went into stealth in front of my eyes. I see you. I see you. There we go. All right. Yeah, I think this just leads back to where we just came from, right? But somehow I feel obliged to kill these people here as well. Nice. And yeah, I think the Templars in there, they just keep on respawning, so there's really no point in trying to kill them, because once you turn your back on them, they just reappear. And apparently the same holds true for these guys over here. So I think at some point we just need to move on, because these guys just keep coming back, and there's really no point in trying to kill all of them. But I mean, it's some easily earned XP, you know. Okay, but now let's move on and ignore all other possible enemies. Yeah, this should be the place where we want to go. Yeah, see some red dots. That sounds like Cullen. Well, that totally is Cullen. I would recognize that voice anywhere. But I have some time to give you a hand here, my love. What a mess. What a mess. Let me taunt all of you. And shattered. And, oh, there's one still alive. Alright, there we go. Yep, that's him. Okay, I think we've dealt with all of him. More red lyrium. That's my man, a commander that leads from the front. I love it. Okay, so enter the Temple of Mythal. So apparently we reached our destination. And now we're going to have a look inside the temple. Ooh. Let's see what mysteries this place holds for us. Let's have a quick save. Just in case the mysteries are dangerous, which they most likely are. Still no use for a supply cache. I'll take the loot though. So you can get rid of this now. Alright. Where do I need to go? Where do I need to go? I think through here. Yes, this is the right way. Okay, let's do this.
That must be the Temple of Mythal.
Be ready. Corypheus will be there.
I hear fighting ahead.
Okay.
Namelana Sabanalen.
They still think to fight us, Master.
Ooh,
these are but remnants. They will not keep us from the Well of Sorrows.
Well of Sorrows?
Be honored. Witness death at the hands of a new god.
Samson doesn't look too well, does he? Um
It cannot be. Across the bridge, now!
Oh dear. Did he just respawn in the body of the Grey Warden? Well, interesting. So, what's next?
At last, Mathal's sanctum. Let us proceed before Corypheus interferes.
If he's here for a mirror, why'd Corypheus say he wants a well of sorrows?
I am uncertain of what he referred to.
Well, maybe they're the same thing.
Could they be the same? Could Illuvian translate into well of sorrows?
No. It seems an Illuvian is not the prize Corypheus seeks.
Yes, I was wrong. Does that please you? Whatever the Well of Sorrows might be, Corypheus seeks it, and thus you must keep it from his grasp.
All right, fair enough.
Let's find this well before Corypheus's people do. I want to know how Corypheus returned to life. We saw him die.
And his life force passes on to any blighted creature, Darkspawn, or Grey Warden.
Then Corypheus cannot die. Destroy his body and he will assume another.
We'll find a way to stop him once we're done here.
'Tis strange. Archdemons possess the same ability, and still the Grey Wardens are able to slay them. Yet Corypheus they locked away. Perhaps they knew he could do this, but not how.
Well, that would explain a lot of things. It would also explain how Corypheus survived the first time that we killed him in the Legacy DLC, because he passed on to... Yeah, Larius, of course. He passed on to Larius. Now that makes sense. Okay, and that also explains why he wanted the Grey Wardens in the first place, so that he could just, you know... For each Grey Warden that he has around him, he has basically one extra life, right? So... I mean, presumably, if we kill him without any of the Grey Wardens around him, then I guess he has nothing where his soul could pass onto, and then he could die? I don't know. Anyway, let's have a look at this place. This is a beautiful place. Yeah, this is really, really beautiful. I love places like these. Old ruins. Forgotten, but still very, very beautiful.
Ooh. It appears the temple's magics are still strong.
Is this elven? Does it say anything about this Well of Sorrows?
Atishol vir Abalasan. It means enter the path of the Well of Sorrows.
There is something about knowledge, respectful or pure. Shivenen. Tis all I can translate. That it mentions the well is a good omen.
Well, I wish I had more than that.
We're out of luck unless one of those temple elves drops a lexicon.
Supplicants to Mathal would have first paid obeisance here. Following their path may aid entry.
Well, can Solus translate this?
Not much of a lock if all you do is step on it.
'Tis a ritual, not a barred door. There is more here than earthly treasure.
Okay, so... complete the ritual to open the door. Okay, so if I step on it, it starts to glow. And my guess would be is that I have to make them all glow, right? Am I doing this right? Oh, this is easy enough.
There! Let us see what awaits.
Yeah, that was pretty easy. Okay, so whatever we did it right. Let me have a quick look around. But I don't see anything else that is interesting. Okay, so I guess we need to go to that door.
I see the Red Templars have already encountered the temple's guardians.
Looks like an ambush. Impressive work.
They hurt themselves for years to get stronger, but they still die so easily.
Perhaps we shall fare better.
Yes, exactly, Cole. Exactly. I've been thinking the same thing. I mean, all the stuff they do to themselves, taking the Red Lurium, and it doesn't really make them that much stronger. Also, it seems that I can... Oh, I talked to Morrigan.
Yes.
Oh, I can talk to her. Okay, let's do this. So, is Corypheus truly immortal?
Are you certain Corypheus is using the power of the Blight to make himself immortal?
Perhaps you forget. I was in Ferelden during the Fifth Blight. I have seen a true archdemon rage. How Corypheus gained the power to send his soul into blighted bodies, that is the real question.
And will answering it help us?
Will answering that question let us destroy Corypheus for good?
Perhaps. I would suggest first dealing with the well. If Corypheus obtains it, any chance of success could be lost.
Fair enough. So, where are we in the temple?
Do you know what this part of the temple was used for?
The room we stand in is a vestibule, not the temple proper. To those who knew it, perhaps this ritual was little more than a polite knock at the gate. These customs must have been as familiar to ancient elves as bowing to a queen is to you or I.
You bow. Well, I mean, she served at the Imperial Court, so I guess she will have a certain manners.
I find it difficult to picture you curtsying to anyone.
Have we become so familiar you can predict my manners and customs now? Nothing is lost by indulging in the occasional civilized conduct, particularly when unexpected.
Interesting. Yeah, tell me about Mythal. I mean, I think I read the Codex entry, but maybe you have some more insights about this.
You said this Mythal was worshipped as a goddess.
So one assumes. What is a god but a being of immense power? The dread old gods were nothing more than dragons, after all. They rise as archdemons, and they die. Perhaps Mythal was a powerful elf, a ruler among her kind. History often plays storyteller with facts.
You admit lack of knowledge, and yet dismiss her so readily?
I do not dismiss her. I question her supposed divinity. One need not be a god to have value. Truthfully, I'm uncertain Mythal was even a single entity. The accounts are varied.
Well, tell me about these accounts.
There are varied accounts of Mythal.
In most stories, Mythal rights wrongs while exercising motherly kindness. Let fly your voice to Mythal, deliverer of justice, protector of sun and earth alike. Other paint her as dark, vengeful. Pray to Mythal and she would smite your enemies, leaving them in agony.
More Dalish tales, I assume.
Well, Solas, if you have something to say about this, then please go ahead.
If you know more about this, Solas, speak.
The oldest accounts say Mythal was both of these, and neither. She was the mother, protective and fierce. That is all I will say. This is not a place to stir up old stories.
Whatever the truth, all accounts of Mythal end the same. Exiled to the beyond with her brethren.
Yeah, tell me more about that.
What do you mean, exiled?
Tricked by the Dread Wolf. as all the elven gods were said to be, trapped in a land beyond the Fade. Many Dalish believe this is why the elves fell from grace, and their gods did not save them. Or perhaps they were simply rulers slain by Tevinter. Who can say?
And yeah, who are these Templars that keep attacking us?
You've seen the elves here. They seem odd.
Indeed. Two things are possible. One, this is a group of Dalish separated from their brethren, cultists, fanatic in their desire to keep humans away. Two, these are elves descended from the ancients, having resided here since before the fall of Arlathan. The second appears unlikely, but if true, the implications are astounding.
Well, apparently this is one of my perks, so yeah, it would be unheard of.
If they keep records, it could change everything we thought we knew about history.
'Tis thrilling, no? To discover an era thought lost forever has possibly thrived in the shadows. We may, however, find these elves reluctant to part with their long-kept secrets.
True. Okay, that was an insightful little chat. I wish Solus would add more to that. I'm sure he knows. He knows a good deal about this stuff. Yeah, let's have a look around here before we continue through that door we just opened. Statue of Fenharel. The rebel god. The Dalish use Harrelan to mean traitor to one's kin, but the word does not appear in any elven text before the Towers Age. The ancient root word is related to Harrelan, or opposition, and Herlethan, or noble struggle. The Dalish call Fenharel a god of deception, but I posit a far more accurate translation would be god of rebellion. What he rebelled against is a story lost to time. In Dalish legends, Fenharel seals away the other deities out of love of trickery. If we understood more ancient elven, we might find earlier versions of the Dreadwolf story give him more nuanced motivation beyond spite. From a treaty of the pagan and heretical customs of the elves by Senelan Tavernier of the University of Orlais, commissioned by Empress Selene.
Why would this be here?
Something wrong.
It depicts the dread wolf, Fenharel. In elven tales, he tricks their gods into sealing themselves away in the beyond for all time. Setting Fenharel in Mathald's greater sanctum is as blasphemous as painting Andraste naked in the chantry.
Yeah, maybe tell the story.
Some chantries display statues of Andraste's betrayer Mafrath as part of the chant.
It might fulfill a similar function. A reminder of vigilance for the faithful.
For all your knowledge, Lady Morrigan, you cannot resist giving legend the weight of history. The wise do not mistake one for the other.
Pray tell, what meaning does our elven expert sense lurking behind this?
None we can discern by staring at it.
You'd make such a cute couple, yeah.
You two look like you're about to kiss when you argue.
It's time we pressed forward.
Agreed.
Apparently they're not amused by my sense of humor. Okay, so well, interesting. When we read about Fenharel before as some sort of trickster god, and I mean, trickster gods are usually ambiguous and not just plain evil, so I figure it would be something similar here. Yeah, I guess this is the door where we need to go, but let me check out the other side of this temple. Well, some loot.
The Temple of Mithal, constructed in an age when elves, not men, dominated this land. They believed Mithal a goddess of justice. Elves came here to request judgment, after they proved their worth.
Silence has reigned here for time beyond memory.
Well, considering that, this place is still in a pretty good shape, though. But yeah, I really like the atmosphere of this place. It's, you know, beautiful, but at the same time it's kind of sad. But I really like it here. Okay, I think we have looked at everything here, so maybe we should just move on. There we go. Ooh. So, where does this lead us next? Oh. Well, they're not exactly subtle.
Hold them off!
Yeah, good luck with that. Hall of Shrines. Okay, we have a bunch of Red Templars to kill. Solas, why don't you take care of these guys and put an ice mine here. And that should... You didn't cast Pull of the Abyss, did you? Oh, you did. Well, don't see it. So. But I mean, they stepped in the ice mine anyway, so it could work. Something is attacking Solon. Let's have a look at that. Might be the guy over here.
You can't hurt me.
And there's someone over here.
Come on, we might catch them. Hold a moment. While they rush ahead, this leads to our true destination. We should walk the petitioner's path as before.
People are dying outside while we stand here. If we use the tunnel, more of our soldiers can flee.
In this case, I must agree with the witch. This is ancient ground, deserving of our respect.
You see the urgency. We cannot find the Well of Sorrows unprepared.
Yeah, we want the world, don't you?
You're very eager to reach our destination.
Are we not all eager to stop Corypheus from achieving his mad plan? Hm.
It sounds like what you want is that well.
There is a danger to the natural order. Legends walked Thedas once, things of might and wonder. Their passing has left us all the lesser. Corypheus would squander the ancient power of the well. I would have it restored.
You're romantic.
I wasn't expecting your answer to be so romantic.
Trust me, your surprise is matched only by my own. Mankind blunders through the world, crushing what it does not understand. Elves, dragons, magic. The list is endless. We must stem the tide or be left with nothing more than the mundane. This I know to be true. I read more in the first chamber than I revealed. It's said a great boon is given to those who use the Well of Sorrows, but at a terrible price.
So what's this boon and the price?
What exactly did that altar say about the Well of Sorrows?
Like most elven writing, it was insufferably vague. The term I deciphered was Halam Shivanas, the sweet sacrifice of duty. It implies the loss of something personal for duty's sake, yet for those who served at this temple, a worthwhile trade.
Yeah, of course there's a price.
What sort of curse should we brace ourselves for if we use the well?
'Twould be easier by far to advise you of a curse. This price is not so well defined. My priority is your cause, but if the opportunity arises to save this well, I am willing to pay the cost.
And gain what?
That is what we must discover. The rituals may point the way.
Alright. Follow Samson through the hole or perform the rituals. Okay, I see. I have to make a choice here. But yeah, the episode is long enough, so I think this is a good time to end the episode. And in the next episode, we will have to decide if we just jump down the hole like Samson did, or if we're going to do the rituals. So yeah, let's see what we're going to do. And thank you for watching, and see you again next time.